Thank you very much for the great love that God is giving unto us, so that we may share the word of God and also we may be encouraged thereby. This day today, we are going to share the word of God from the book of Genesis chapter 6. In Genesis chapter 6, we have verse 5, 6, 7, and 8. And God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. And it repented the Lord that he had made man on the earth, and it grieved him at his heart. And the Lord said, I will destroy man whom I have created from the face of the earth, both man and beast, and the creeping thing that and the fowls of the air, and it repented me that I have made them. But Noah found grace in the eyes of God. God has a loving heart, and the love that God has for us is a love that can never be understood by man. From the beginning of the creation of God, God had a plan to make man to be like him, to have the image also as him. And as you know very well that the image of God is his spirit, and the likeness of God is the righteousness and the holiness and the perfection that he is able to give to man that is of his character, these things, God had a plan that they should come to man, but man, who was made by God, he defiled himself. How? By accepting the heart of Satan. So when man received the heart of Satan, from that very time, man became sinful, man became evil, man went against God. Then, Bible is telling us that when God saw man, how did God see man? God saw that in the heart of man, there was only evil, and not only once or twice, but it was continuous. When you think about God, who is really thinking of man? Yeah, here we can see the hearts, and here we have six different types of hearts. So the first heart is a heart which has no sin. The second heart is a heart which has some small sin. The third heart is a heart which have like almost a quarter sin. But the fourth heart is 50-50. 50 sin, 50 good. And the fifth one is 75. Almost full. And now the last one is 100% evil. And then when we look at the hearts of men, then people, they have different perspective when they are looking at the heart. Some people, they think, me, I have small sin. Others, they think, me, I have only halfway. Others, they think, even though I may be a bad man, but also I help people. But always, people, they don't think that they can have 100% evil in their hearts. Why? Because the devil has always cheated man that they can do well. And because they think they can do well, then they have never thought of they are 100% evil. So when we think about God, God is talking to us about human being. So who is human being? Human being originated from Adam. And Adam, he had received the evil spirit. And this evil spirit came from who? This evil spirit came from Satan. So when you think about the evil spirit which came from Satan, then made the heart of man to be filled with sin. For example, in the Garden of Eden, Adam and his wife Eve, they ate from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Then, how did they come to eat? They ate because they were cheated by Satan. What does it mean by being cheated? They received the heart of Satan, and they believed in this heart, and that's why they went against God. So, when you think about Adam, there's also another picture that I want to show you. Then, here, we can see Adam. Adam was the first man, and he is the one that was given the word by God, that thou may eat of every fruit which is in the garden of Eden, but that which is of the knowledge of good and evil, thou shalt not eat of it, for in the day that you eat of it, you shall surely die. So all human beings, they became sinners, not because they committed sin, not because they ate, but because of this one man, Adam, who ate, and after eating, then whoever was born out of Adam also became a sinner. So we can see ourselves. Like here we can see me. Now this is our position, me. So in this position of me, then how did I become a sinner? How did you become a sinner? So mankind became a sinner not because they committed sin, but because they were shapen in iniquity, and in sin did their mothers conceive them. So we were conceived in sin, which means we did not commit any sin to become a sinner. We never did anything wrong to become a sinner, but we were shapen and we were conceived in sin. And that's why many people, they cannot understand the context of the heart of God relating or showing us who we are before Him. So many times we may think, I am a good man. I am the one who can do well. I am the one who can do this and that. But problem is, from the time Adam sinned, from the time Adam received the evil spirit, from that time, every human being that was born under the sun also had sin. And then Adam was chased from the Garden of Eden. Then it means all mankind had been chased already. So every human being had been chased already. Therefore, to go back to God does not depend on us. It does not depend on our goodness. It does not depend on anything that we may do. There's another thing that I want to show you. Here we have a tree. And now this tree is a tree that we can call of it maybe as apple tree or orange tree. So let's talk of orange tree. Let's talk of orange tree. So according to Matthew chapter 7, verse 17, Bible says, even so, every good tree bringeth forth good fruit, but a corrupt tree bringeth forth evil fruit. Verse 18, a good tree cannot bring forth evil fruit, neither can a corrupt tree bring forth good fruit. Every tree that bringeth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire. So Bible is telling us that every tree, even so, every good tree bring forth good fruit. So what does it mean, bringing forth good fruit? It means if the good fruit was planted, then the fruit will, if the good seed was planted, then the fruit will be good. But if a corrupt seed was planted, then the evil fruit will be produced. And therefore, a good seed which has brought forth a good tree can never bring forth an evil fruit. For example, if you plant mango, what will come out? Only mango fruit will come out. If you plant orange seed, only orange fruit will come out. If you plant banana, only banana will come out. Apple, only apple will come out. Grapes, only grapes will come out. So according to the seed that has been planted, that is what the fruit will be. But now we have a tree which is mango seed, and it is a mango tree. Can it bring forth banana? A mango seed which has brought forth a mango tree, can it bring forth grapes? Can it bring forth apples? Then it becomes impossible. So it is hard. That's why every good tree will only bring forth good fruit. And every corrupt tree will only bring forth evil fruit. That's why human being, what had been planted in them. So if you look at Isaiah chapter 1, then the Bible will tell us what was planted inside man. Isaiah chapter 1, verse 4. So what was planted? In Isaiah chapter 1, when you look at verse 4, the Bible is telling us, a sinful nation, a people laden with iniquity, a seed of evildoers, children that are corruptible or corruptors, have provoked the Holy One of Israel unto anger. They are gone away backward. So here, the seed of evildoers. So human being is a seed. Yeah, New King James say brood of evildoers. So a seed of evildoers or a brood of evildoers, it means then the seed that was planted is the seed of evil, doing evil. So human being, what was planted in them? There is nothing that was planted. There is nothing good that was planted inside man. In man, only evil things were planted. In man, only corruptible things were planted. From when? From the time of Adam and Eve. From the Garden of Eden, from the time Adam received the mind of his wife, and the wife received it from Satan, and now from that point, man became corrupt. Man became filled with the evil spirit. And that's why man should know what is his origin and what has he been made of. Yes, we have been made of the dust of the ground. Yes, we have received the breath of God. Yes, but what else? We have the evil spirit. From when? From the time Adam and Eve, they disobeyed the word of God. So man who does not know himself should know himself that there's nothing good in him. So what is in him? According to Ecclesiastes chapter 9 verse 3, Bible is saying that which is inside man is only but filled with evil. So the Bible says the heart of man, this is an evil in all that is done under the sun, that one thing happens to all. Truly, the hearts of the sons of men are full of evil. Madness is in their hearts while they live, and after that, they go to the dead. So, Bible is telling us that the hearts of men are full of evil, which means 100% full, not 20%, not 70%, not 50%, but the heart of man is full, 100% full of evil. Not only evil, man is a mad max, a mad person. Human being is a mad person. Even though may seem to be normal, even though may seem to be laughing, but Bible is saying man is mad. And that's why when you look at the way men react and the way men they do their things, then what does it mean? It means that God is telling us clearly that man is full of evil, that is 100%, and at the same time, man is mad. He is a mad max. So human being has nothing good in them. And that's why Apostle Paul, in the book of Romans chapter 7, from verse 18, 19, and 20, the Bible says that even though he man want to do good, but he cannot do good. Why? Because only evil is in him. For the good that I will to do, I do not do, but the evil which I will not to do, that I practice. Then verse 20 is telling us, now if I do what I will not to do, it is no longer I who do it, but sin that dwells in me. So Apostle Paul discovered himself exactly. He discovered who he was before God. And that's why he could not trust in himself. So also, Romans chapter 7, verse 24, Bible is talking of Paul. So what did Paul say? O wretched man that I am, who will deliver me from this body of death? So Apostle Paul discovered the body that he was having. Himself, he was just a mass of death, a mass of sin. And that's why he could not trust in himself. He never trusted in himself. Then there's this one man called Noah. So Bible is talking to us that God really wanted to punish the world when Noah was living. And that's why God said, now, in the heart of man, there's nothing that is there. Their imagination and whatever they think of is only evil continually. Noah discovered this heart. He knew for sure, I am a human being. There's nothing good in me. That which is in me is only evil. Only evil. And if it comes to destruction, then I'm the one who should be destroyed. I don't need to live. Truly, if God is to destroy the world, and if God is to destroy mankind, then that is what it is. Even me, I am that evil. So, in verse 5 of Genesis chapter 6, Bible is talking to us and is saying, and God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. Not even once, not even until you become a youthful age or a mature man. No, evil continually. Evil continually means until one goes back to the grave. Until one goes back to the grave, one is only evil continually. But now people, they think, no, sometimes I'm good. I can do good. And that's why they are cheated. And that's why you can see some people, they think, I have a heart which is having like 150% sin or evil and 50% good. Or maybe 25% evil, but 75% good. Or it's just 10% evil and 90% good. No, there's nothing like that. Bible say, in the heart of man, there's nothing good, only evil continually. From the time of birth to the time of death. From the time the flesh came into being until the flesh will be separated from the soul and go back to the ground. So Bible is talking to us and is telling us that man is only evil. Man has nothing good in him. And that's why we need to think deeply about these aspects. When we think about the heart of Noah, he reached in verse 6 also. And it repented the Lord that he had made man on the earth, and it grieved him at his heart. And the Lord said, I will destroy man whom I have created from the face of the earth, both man and beast, and the creeping thing, and the fowls of the air, for it repenteth me that I have made them. So God was not happy because of man. God was not happy. And now, as you know, everything that was made for man. And that's why now God is destroying everything. He's destroying the beast, he's destroying the creeping things and birds of the air. He's destroying them. Why? Because they were made for man. And now that man has gone against God, and man is now defiled, man does not have the heart of God. So God say, there's no need. If I'm to destroy, then I destroy man. And if I'm to destroy, I'm to destroy the beasts. If I'm to destroy, I'm to destroy the birds and destroy every creeping thing that lives, that has life in it. So God decided to destroy. In the heart of Noah, he could sit down and think of it. Why should man destroy mankind? Why should all animals die? Why should the birds in the air die? Why should the creeping things die? Because of man. What is the problem of man? In the heart of man is full of evil. In the heart of man, there is only madness. And then Noah, when he discovered this, he said, surely I am wrong. He discovered himself. He knew how he was so wrong, so evil in the eyes of God. And then from that time, he said, surely I am wrong. So Noah discovered himself. Noah discovered how evil he was. And because he discovered this, then that is the time when God also could think of him and God could talk to him, and God could give him a way to escape from the judgment that was coming that time. So who can receive the grace of God? Who can live? Only them who discover that there's nothing good in me. I am the one who is so evil. I am the one who is so dirty. I am the one who cannot do it. And because of this, I am able to surrender before God. So many people today, they don't know themselves. And because they don't know themselves, this brings big problem and big destruction in the life of man. Not only man, but also in the life of the things that are around them. So human being who does not obey God, human being who don't know himself, will always make everything that has been created by God to be destroyed. Why are they getting destroyed? Because man has gone against God. And everything that was made for man. But now man has gone against God. That's why God will destroy man plus the thing that God had made for him. Noah discovered one thing. I am evil. There's nothing good in me. I am the one who is going against God. And the judgment of God is coming to me. Oh Lord, have mercy on me. I am the one who cannot do anything. I am the one who can only but destroy everything. So how can I live? How can I survive? How can I escape this judgment that is coming? Only them who have discovered who they are and how they are will always surrender before God. I am so evil. I have nothing good in me. I am only but a mad max. I'm a madman. There's nothing good. And I am the one who is supposed to be judged, supposed to be destroyed, supposed to be killed in the judgment of God. Noah discovered this. In life today, who can beg? Who can beg? Not anyone can beg. Only them who are poor, not only poor, but are hungry, can beg. Oh, please, give me some food. Oh, please, give me some money. Oh, please, help me. Who can beg? Not anyone can beg. Because people, they are so proud. Not only proud, they are really very generous to themselves. And therefore, they don't want to lower their dignity. They don't want to be ashamed. That's why they cannot beg so easily. But now if you see somebody's begging, please help me, then it means, he has no way. So what is grace? Noah, the Bible says Noah found grace in the sight of God. And then how did he find grace? He found grace after knowing that I am evil. I am evil. Only them that have discovered that they are evil, they can ask for grace. So the grace of God is given to who? The grace of God is given to them who are lacking. Is given to them who cannot do anything. Is given to them who have been defeated. Not anyone can say, I need grace. And I want to tell you that many people, for them to realize that they need grace, first, they have to try. And then when you try, and then you fail, and then you try again. Then you try, you fail, then you try again. So when you continuously try and fail, try and fail, try and fail, then you will discover, I'm the one who cannot make it by myself. That's why I need a helper. Who can help me? Apostle Paul is saying, oh, wretched man that I am, who will save me, who will deliver me from this body of death? Apostle Paul, he has discovered, I am the one who cannot help myself. I cannot save myself. Only them who have discovered that they cannot save themselves, they cannot help themselves, they are the people who can surrender. Who will help me? Who can help me? Who will save me? Noah discovered this very fact. Who will save me? I need a savior. Many Christians today, they have this one simple heart. I can keep the law. I can do well. If I decide, I can do it. But they have never failed. That's why they are saying, I can do it. In religious life, people, they have resolutions. And now resolutions means that, okay, this year, okay, last year, I could not do well. But now at the beginning of the year, this is now the first day of this year, January, then I really want to live well. I really want to live well. I really want to do well. I really want to keep the law. I really want to be so much righteous. Then they try and try. After 3-4 weeks, they fall. Then, okay, I will try again during Passover. I will try again during Easter. Or I will try again when our conference comes, then I will now make it and then try again. So whenever such times come, they try, they fall. Whenever such time they come, and then they try, they fall. And then until they say, I cannot do it, then they throw it away and carry up their hands and say, Lord, I have been defeated. What can I do now? Then from that time, the Lord will come to help you. Who can be helped by God? Only them who have tried and they have failed. Who can be helped by others? Only them who have tried and they have failed. And not only trying and failing, but acknowledging that I cannot do it. And I have failed completely. So when you acknowledge, when you discover this fact that I cannot make it, I cannot do it, then from that point, you are able to receive somebody who can help you. So Jesus Christ, he came into this world to tell us, hey, you people, you cannot do it. You cannot make it. Therefore, I am here for you. During the time of Noah. And now during the time of Noah, we can see clearly that people, they had to know one more fact. That I am not having anything good. So Noah, he could also surrender. Okay. I cannot hold on to sin. I cannot control my sin. I cannot make on it. Therefore, I will hand it over. Then he could cast it over to who? To the Lamb. And who is the Lamb? The Lamb is Jesus. And that's why Noah, he could get a way to escape from death. Which way? The way of making the ark. And now that ark was to save who? The ark was to save Noah. Who gave him that ideology? Who gave him that idea? The idea came from God. How to escape judgment. How to escape death. So God, time to time, is showing us how we can come out of death, how we can come out of judgment, how we can come out of calamities that may come to us. And that's why we are the people who have to know, I cannot make it. And then you look for a remedy. You look for a help. You look for how to be helped out of it. So them who discover I cannot make it, they have to surrender before God. They have to give up. And when they give up, the Lord will take control over everything. Noah did not know what to do. And that's why God brought the ark for him. So in the Old Testament, we have the ark of Noah. In the Old Testament, we have the angels saving Lot from that Sodom and Gomorrah. In the Old Testament, we have the tabernacle, and now the Israelites being saved from their sin, and now the calamity of sin did not come to them. Why? Because they could hand over their sin to the innocent animal, and the animal could die instead of them. So, time to time, season to season, God was bringing a way to escape from judgment, a way to escape from sin, because all they have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. But now, how could they come out? So, let's see Romans chapter 3, and the Bible is talking to us about man who have fallen into sin, and they are all gone astray. In Romans chapter 3, we have verse 23. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, being justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. So what does it mean? Even in the times of Noah, everyone had gone astray. Everyone had gone astray, was evil together with Noah. But who found grace? The one that is finding grace is the one that I've discovered. There's nothing good in me. I cannot do it. I cannot make it. Therefore, Lord, have mercy on me. Noah discovered this, that I need grace. I cannot do it. We have all fallen. I cannot do anything. I have tried A and B, C, but I have failed. Therefore, I need the grace of God. I need the help of God. I need a helping hand. Apostle Paul also cried, "O wretched man that I am, who shall save me from this body of death?" And then he discovered that he cannot save himself. That's why they could receive Savior. They could receive way of salvation. Noah received way of salvation through the ark. And then he found grace in the sight of God. He found grace in the eyes of God. How could he find grace? Because he discovered, I cannot make it. Please help me. Please help me. And then we are now shouting to them that are trying to make it by themselves. Come on, you cannot make it. Carry up your hand. Discover that you have been defeated. You are so evil. And there's nothing good. That's why we need our Lord, Savior. He came to save us. He came to give us grace. He came to remove us from condemnation. He came to remove us from death. He came to remove us from hellfire. To who? To them that have discovered, yes, I have lived my Christian life for 10 years. I have lived my Christian life for 20 years. I have lived my Christian life for 30 years. But now, did I become righteous? No, I have been still a sinner up to now. Then what should I do? For the last 20 years I've been in the church. 30 years I've been in the church. 40 years I've been in the church. But still I am a sinner. Then where am I going? Surrender before God. The Lord will give you mercy. Surrender before God. He will help you. He will give you hope. And this hope is found in our Lord Jesus Christ. So only them who believe in Jesus, only them who believe in the grace that is gotten through him can receive salvation. They can escape the judgment of God. That's why grace is given to who? And now, what is grace? Grace is a free gift. You don't work for it. We receive it by faith, by hearing what the Lord has done for us. And then who can receive it? Only them who have been defeated. Not only defeated, I have also discovered that there's nothing good in me. And if I don't get the help of God, then hellfire is waiting for me. So grace is given to who? Grace is given to them who have discovered, I cannot do it. I am equally evil. I am equally wrong. And then I am able to receive the gift and the preparation of God. Them who go to heaven, they are not going to heaven because they are better than others. And them who go to hell, they are not going to hell because they are more evil than others. All are same. All have sinned and committed sin, which means they have fallen short of the glory of God. But by the grace of God, others are going to heaven. While them who have not received the grace, they are going to hellfire. So going to hellfire means I have rejected the way of God. Going to hellfire means I have rejected the work of God. That's why they say, I am a sinner. Who is a sinner? A sinner have rejected the work of God. That's why we need to think deeply. Noah found grace in the eyes of God because he discovered that without God, without that remedy, I cannot make it. Lord, have mercy on me. And that's how he was blessed. May God also bless you and make you escape from the judgment that is coming. Thank you.